So virtual production is a brand new area in which the whole concept is, can we use real-time rendering properties of a game engine to do real-time visual effects work or real-time animation work or real-time broadcast television work? So whereas in a traditional CG pipeline, I would click render and it might take me 10 minutes a frame, 2 hours a frame. The game engine is designed to spit out imagery as fast as possible because the player needs that in order to continue playing. We saw some major cases of that being used in The Mandalorian, but we're also seeing that in feature film animation. We're also seeing that in broadcast television. For example, BBC, for their Olympics coverage, they didn't fly people to Japan. They had people sitting in the studio in London on a green screen and just made it look like they were in Japan. So we recently created some new classes, which are Intro to Virtual Production 2, and Visual Effects Production. And each of these three classes really focus on this new and emerging way of creating content, specifically CG content or VFX content, that is brand new in the film industry. And students are actively learning that same content here so that they can get hired by the time that they graduate. So in Intro to Virtual Production, students are getting their hands on Unreal Engine, and this is a mixture of game students who have been using Unreal to create video games, and film students who have no idea what we're doing in the game engine, but understand film concepts, how to use a camera, how to use lights, and all of those come together to create full CG films using live motion capture actors and virtually tracked real cameras to digital cameras. So in that class, which is a 10-week class, students are going to break out into groups and create actually three different series of short films using pre-made assets so that we're not focusing on all the CG content creation, but really how do we put that together and how do we tell short stories using this pre-made content with our own stories, with our own actors, and do it to a really high level. After that, we have our Virtual Production 2, which basically takes all of those concepts that they've learned in the first one and pushes it to a higher level. Basically, it's not exactly creating new material, but it's about giving students repetition, right? Now we've done it before, we've done it three times, let's continue to do it to refine those skills. And that's the thing about this new area is there are all these problems that professionals are still trying to figure out because it's still sort of in the works of what's the proper way in which we do all of this stuff. Virtual production is so exciting to me because it's so synergistic. The more we do it, the more students realize where their skill sets are and where their skill sets are not, right? So again, I have these game students who understand how to create compelling environments, to create these beautiful worlds and make them interactive. But I also have film students who know how to shoot in beautiful spaces and make them look compelling in films. And they both don't cross over, you know, to do the other one. It really pulls on the best of my game environment artists or character artists. It pulls on the best of my animation students to create compelling animation on top of the motion capture that we're doing. And it pulls from the film students because we need them to light it well. We need them to film it well. We need them to give us what does that film vision look like. And then it requires compositors and other visual effects artists to take this sort of clean, pristine, CG, clear cut, you know this is terrible visual effects type of look, and deteriorate that image, make it look photoreal, and so it does look compelling rather than sort of cheap CG. It really pulls from so many of the areas at this university, and that's why it's so cool because there aren't a lot of places that are doing this to the level that we are. Filmmakers, professional filmmakers, are realizing that this is a thing. This is an area in which they want to expand, and yet have absolutely no clue how to do it because they don't understand a game engine. There's no reason they should. And so I have all of these game students who have this ability, even though they perhaps never thought of going this direction because it never existed, but there are all these jobs opened up to them. I actually have companies that have called saying, hey, do you have somebody who can work on this? Like, we need an environment for a film set that we're going to be shooting next week. Do you have people? And so we've made a couple really, really strong connections in this space. One of them is AMGI Studios in Burbank. And they're a small studio focusing on virtual production and doing many of the things that we're doing just to a slightly higher level. So they're doing live motion capture to fully CG characters. They're creating environments in Unreal and creating films. They have a feature film deal with Netflix that they're gonna start producing in this summer that some of my alumni are working on. They took my Intro to Virtual Production class and got hired at AMGI because they understood what they were doing at the studio. With the first class, students had the ability to go directly into their pipeline. And in my Virtual Production 2 class, I actually took the whole class up to the studio to see the alumni, see what they were up to, and also give the other students a really, really in-depth understanding of what is it that they're doing there. And they want to hire as many of my students as they possibly can. They are constantly looking for more people. Again, like, they're going to be beefing up for creating a feature film, all using virtual production techniques. So using Unreal Engine, using motion capture for CG characters, to a Pixar level type of animation quality is their goal. And so they need these people who understand all of the language from these sort of random areas. And that's the whole idea with virtual production. And that's what we're doing in class.
My name is Sam Lamarck. I am story lead for DeCapo. DeCapo is a first-person horror game.